So sorry about all these buckets. We seem to have sprung a leak. Well, several, actually.
You're going to need a whole new lining up there. Triple sealed, I shouldn't wonder.
We'll look into it.
Minister, it's so good to see you again.
Miss Wolfe, your star seems to be in the ascendant.
It's a great time to be alive.
Too bloody right. Peter Clement.
Megan Wolfe.
My, but that's a firm handshake you've got there.
She's tougher than she looks.
Am I here?
Here, with Mr. Clement on your left.
Right you are, pet. Is your seat damp?
10 seconds, everybody.
No, mine's fine.
Have you had a little accident?
She's a cow.
5, 4, 3.
Welcome back. I am delighted to be joined by Prime Ministers Julia Salisbury and Peter Clement. Welcome to the National Nightly News, Prime Ministers.
Oh, please, it's just Julia and Peter.
We don't believe much in titles. It doesn't seem very advanced.
We're delighted to be here.
Well, firstly, I should ask how you feel about the graffiti that's been springing up across the capital. Should we be worried?
Oh, no. No, you definitely shouldn't be worried.
Well, not unless you've got a fatal paint allergy anyway.
But yes, it does seem that there are still some people we haven't been able to help.
You know, whingers mostly.
People who've yet to benefit from the many advantages of the new future.
And you know, Megan, as my old mam used to say, there are some pissants who just don't know how to be happy.
We're working hard to reach these people, find out what they're angry about and how we can help. The door to my government is always open.
Someone's dripping on me.
But we didn't come here to talk about what may yet turn out to be some alternative arts project.
Which we no doubt will have funded.
When we want to talk to the nation about something far more exciting.
Yes, your office briefed us that you have an announcement to make, but they were being surprisingly secretive about it.
Let me ask you a question, Megan.
Oh, okay, it's not usually how it works, but...
What scares you? I mean, really scares you?
It's death, pet. She's talking about death.
We're all afraid of our deaths. It's part of being human.
Sorry, are you saying that advance have cured death?
That'd be a vote winner. Yep, that was definitely a drop there.
But while we may not have cured death, we hope we found a way to make it much less scary.
And much less painful and much less expensive. Look, which is me close-up camera,
Oh,
Pet?
Sorry, yes, it's camera four right there.
When I was 13, me mam came and got me from school. He had to go to the hospital. My granddad, he'd collapsed that morning. So we'd all to say our goodbyes. And I went in to see him. He were all frail and pale. And I was scared because I'd only seen him the week before and he'd been fit as fiddle. And he said to me, "Petey," he said, "it's the right time. I don't ever want to be a burden to the people I love."
Was that the last time you saw him?
Nope. 3 days later, we were back home. He lived with us for 9 miserable years after that. He had to be fed with a rubber spoon. He had a commode, so he'd just take a shit right there in the lounge while we were watching football. He wouldn't even wait till half time.
That sounds...
It were awful. It were awful for us. And this is the point. It were awful for him. He could see it was destroying me, ma'am, watching him slowly fade away. And he would beg her to turn off his breathing equipment at night, but she couldn't. Or she wouldn't. It were a crime, you see. And she didn't want to lose the children as well as her old man.
No family should have to suffer like Peter's did. And now no family will have to. The health service is today opening the first of 300 new transition centres.
The transition centres will handle everything for your last days. The legal, financial, medical and emotional costs are all catered for and paid for by the government. So even the poorest citizen gets to pass on with dignity when they choose.
And that choice is important.
Yes.
This is a service only for people who choose it. For people who feel they've run their course and don't want to burden themselves or their families with a slow, long, humiliating decline into an
Jesus! Fuck! This microphone pack has just given me an electric shock!
Are you okay?
I don't know. I think it fried my arsehole!
Oh, we're still on the air, Peter.
Oh, yes. Sorry. My apologies.
Are you not worried that this new system might be open to abuse.
In what way?
Well, shit! Nuts! Sorry, I got zapped again. Can I get a little bit of help here? Please!
That the older generation might feel somewhat...
Jesus, a Rochelle face, fucker! That one were massive! Right, no, this bastard's coming off!
That the older generation might feel somewhat coerced.
Coerced into spending their final days eating gourmet food and drinking fine wine and luxury spas and gardens.
Look, I am perfectly capable of... Oh, fuck! My grandmother with a rusty twat!
Prime Minister, please watch your language.
For fuck's sake!
Go get yourself sorted out.
Right.
We're launching a government information film tonight. It should tell your viewers everything they need to know.
You really do move at a breathless pace. It's hard to believe you've yet to be in office a year.
Oh, Megan, we're only getting started.
And on that note, thank you both so much for being here. Jeremy.
Right, yes, that's all we have time for tonight. Thank yous go out to our guests. Congratulations to all the winners at the Sports Board Final. And we'll see you tomorrow night at the same time. My name's Jeremy Donaldson. If you can, have a peaceful night.
And we're out. Good job, everybody.
So they just...
The same, sir.
I don't suppose there's any way this could be a good thing.
It's my nephew, so I'll be transitioned the moment I start the leak.